come from the world, Mabroni, Mondial, Moneybox. It is a community which was started way back in 1989 in Russia by a mathematician called Sergei Mavrodi. Sergei Mavrodi himself is a mathematician, he's a banker, and somebody who is so much versed in the financial system. He created softwares which are used in financial systems in Russia in that year. Just like Mavrodi, you remember there are cases of people like Bill Gates. There are people who have been very much fundamental in software which we are using in the computer. So Sergei was one of such type of personalities. Don't worry about that, I'll bring you the whole idea. So MMM was started because of our purpose. And I want to take you through what we call ideology of MMM. So MMM, number one, is not a business. It's not a bank, it's not even a hype. When I talk of a hype, what does it means a highly paid investment program. So MMM is neither of those. But MMM is something very, very important, as we will just unravel all its ideology and to you why MMM was started. So in early those years, around 1994, Sergei came across a system, being a banker, he said that why are people, ordinary people, taking their money to the bank, taking their money to all other investment facilities, but they don't get the truth. So what pains his heart was the idea of where is the truth? Why are people not told the truth? Because you take your money to the bank, it stays there, after 1 year you come back, you have 1 million. Probably now it's just maybe 1,100,000 shillings on top of it. But there's a truth which the banker or financial investor, the investor does not tell you. What does they don't tell you is that they make almost 1,500% with every money given to them. But you as an ordinary person, you don't reap much from the big hefty benefits they are getting from your money. If you take your money to the insurance companies, yes, basically you know that it's all about indemnity. But there are so much, many other investment facilities, there are so many places like trust and what you can name it. They don't tell you the truth about your money. You are the person who will take your money there in your own volition and put it there. Of course, you know it will do some investment. But what they get is a windfall. It's much, much, much more than what you can get as an investor there. So these are some of the questions which were ringing in the heart of this mathematician. Because he knew the banking system, how the banking is going about, the financial system of those banks, and many other things. But he's saying that, why don't people benefit in this great, in such a great thing, in a great way? Why do bankers take this much? Yet, they don't benefit people. Whatever you are selling in the bank, it does not benefit you. Why? So these are things which pain people. He was asking the question that, why is somebody laboring in the shamba for a whole day, but it's the one who is least paid? Why is somebody who come and do very hard task, but he is getting very little pay? Yes, somebody working in the bank is just shuffling through papers and connecting a few deals, but he's laughing all the way to the bank when the end of the month comes. He drives a good car and all is moving well. But why is that person who we consider to be doing even the harder task is getting nothing, nothing, nothing? So Mavrodi said, or in term, this as what we call unjust financial system. So when MMM was formed, this was the main ideology, to come and bring a correction to to what we call the unjust financial system. You see, because the modern world, as you can see here, the modern world is inhuman, it is unjust. All the systems which were created is like they were created to oppress people who are getting little money. You find that somebody who is just earning peanuts, laboring in the shamba, this child cannot go to college, university, so that their life can be changed. So it means such a people, they will be in a vicious cycle of failure. Nothing good can happen to them because the world system is already unjust. You see? So my brother is talking so much about unjust financial system. You see? And this unjust financial system, it is like it has been accepted in the old world that this is how the world is supposed to be. And nobody should question about it. So it's like we are seeing that when you look at the financial system, I'm very much happy because there are servants of God in this place. And that is very good. I remember sometime we were praying in Kenya House of Prayer, and we had time to pray about the unjust financial system. For instance, when you go and look at the bank, you find that if you borrow money from the bank, let's say you are looking for 100,000. You want maybe to take your child to school, to university, to college, and so forth, something like that. This 100,000, when you repay it after 1 year or 2 years, there are cases where people are paid another 100,000 on top of, which means now they are paid 100% or 200%. You see? So when Christians were examining the world system of finances, they see that there is what we call unjust financial system in the world. And you know why the unjust financial system is there? The unjust financial system is here to oppress the poor. Which means the poor person can never arise and become better off financially. Not unless a miracle happens. You see? The person who is laboring in the shamba the whole day, there is no day he will take his child to a better school, and in the end of the day, that generation becomes renewed and they become people who can earn a better result or better income. You see? So you find that that cycle of failure, it keeps on going on and on because of the world and just financial system in the world. For the son, don't worry about that. We are really talking. So, my brother is again saying, what can rectify such unjust situation in the world? Yeah? In the year 2011, MMM Global was started. MMM Global is a community. Let me go some steps behind. Let me start from the very beginning. We have talked about ideology of MMM. So MMM Global was started so that the unjust financial system can be crushed. You see? So what is this MMM? MMM is a community of about 200 million members across the world. MMM is in 118 countries of the world. MMM is now in Kenya, Uganda, Tanzania, many African countries. MMM has put a big base in South Africa. If you watch many videos, you will see what is happening in the community of MMM. You see? So MMM became what we call peer-to-peer financial aid program. MMM is just offering you that technical program where you can benefit, because it has been created for the sole purpose of donating money. It is called a donation program. It means you give money to somebody in the community. That excess money you have, you give it to somebody, time when they need it, and you will also come back to the community the time when you need that money, and the members of the community will also lend to you. That's why MMM came into being. So MMM is here to bring what we call financial justice. Because when people share money among themselves, because that is the purpose of MMM, it will break that financial problem. You see, now instead of going to the bank and going to other institutions which are overcharging the poor and making the life very difficult, MMM was founded so that members in MMM, they can share financials among each other. That's why we call MMM a global financial program, where members share finances with each other. It is also founded in the principles of the apostles. You know, in the time of apostles, people brought money. They sold their shambas, they sold their houses, and they brought it in their house at the feet of the apostles. That is the Acts of Apostles chapter 2. So after they brought it at the feet of the apostles, they distributed to everyone according to their needs. So MMM is also operating inside platform. Because what you will do, you donate money. Somebody who is in need. Suppose you donate like $10, $100, $50, $10,000, any amount you can donate. But now the time when it comes for your turn, something unique will happen. What will happen? You get the much you donated with up to 30% on top of it. If you don't redeem it, what happens? It keeps on growing and multiplying. At the time you also come to the system to get it, members of the community will give it for you, to you, for free, without any obligation, without asking you to sign somewhere so that you can be made before a lawyer or something of that nature. So MMM has been created to create that what we call financial injustice across the world. So we are a global community. I'm going to tell you about MMM. It's called Mabrodi Money or Money Box. Because Mabrodi, those are just the surnames of the founders of MMM, as they originated as a community, also as a business, offline business. Money means it is across the world. MMM is now across the world. It is global community. Money Box means it is a place whereby you give somebody help with your finances. But the time when you also need money or help, you also come back to MMM and ask for help, for financial support, and you get it there. But there is a big difference. It won't just be normal or something normal like that. For instance, if you donate $10 or $100, you don't just expect to come back to the community and get only $100. And that's why there is a mathematical formula in the system, whereby when you donate your finances and you come back later, now you get it to 30%. When you don't redeem that 30%, it keeps on growing and growing and growing. I'm just going on and on a little bit so that you just get the general concept of the whole idea. Because there are so many people here who are new to the system and you want a proper introduction. And that's why I've decided to do it in the part of introduction. After I've introduced, I will call my colleague, he's also somebody in the making, he's also a guy in the making, he will only talk about benefits of MMM. But now I want you to understand what is MMM. What is this unique thing called MMM? Many people have heard them talking of something that, if you go to that place, where does that money come from? It comes from the devil. They are talking about the devotion. But I want to tell you as a Christian, I'm a Christian myself, but what has made more many Christians go astray or to die is lack of knowledge. When you just say that something is devil, you know, when you talk of devil worshiping, I'm talking about those perspectives because many people here are Christian and they are born again. At least almost 90% of people here. If somebody is talked about devil worshiping means you have to be initiated. If you really read the Bible very deeply. But even in Christianity, you also have to be initiated. How are you becoming initiated in Christianity? It's by calling upon the name of the Lord and confessing your sin. Then you come, you enter the kingdom of God. You are initiated. There are other forms of initiation in Christianity, things like water baptism, being filled with the Holy Spirit. All those are process of initiation in Christianity. Then you are taught the word of God, which means now you are taught the doctrine of the principle of the word of God. In the devil worship, also there is what we call initiation. Then after initiation, there is what we call indoctrination, so that you are brainwashed and you bring in the principles of the devil. Then there are things like sacrifices. There are things of those nature in the devotion. And when you look here, have you seen us slaughtering any chicken or pouring blood anywhere? There's nothing like that. You know, let me just give a little bit of my testimony. I know it will help us. Myself, I'm a researcher, and I write. I do a lot of writing. So one time in the course of my writing, I met people in MMM, and they introduced me to the system. They introduced me to the system from South Africa, online. They were online there. And they're telling me that there is a community where you can give help, and you can also later on come and ask for help, and you get it with 30%. And when you don't redeem it, it keeps on growing and accruing. And I asked them, how does this community work? They told me it is simple. People just donate money to some people, excess money which they can donate to somebody for free. But when they also come back to the community, that system has calculated that how much you have donated and how much you can get at any given time. And so when you come and ask members of the community to give you this online, they also give you for free. And then they told me, now you find that whatever you donated and what you will get in the final analysis for members of the community, it is much than what you donated. And I asked them why. It was created to uplift the life standard of ordinary people who have been facing what we call financial injustices. That was 5 minutes. We finished with him. I was registered online through the Facebook, and that was it. Then I started reading about MMM. There were many people who are writing like me. Like in Facebook, there are Facebook groups. There are people who write. You are in that group. Many of them have become members of MMM in the past, even before me. And some of them became even guiders. They were trained to become guiders, managers for that matter. You will be talking about manager, how to become a manager in MMM. Those are some of the benefits, because we offer free online education. Then most of them, what do? They just simply register and they sat down. And they say, this is a Ponzi scheme. This is a pyramid scheme. That was it. So they need benefit. But so when I got registered, I sat down and did a research and looked at the system. And I said to myself, this system works. I've not even participated. What did I do? I started participating by providing help. That time, I didn't have much money. I only have $10. So I provided help with $10, which means I missed on some of the benefits people get when they do what we call registration, when they provide help in the first time they register with at least $50 onwards. You get some added bonuses. So I didn't get it at all. What did I do? I started to telling people, some other people about MMM. It was very difficult, even today it's still very difficult. But a number of people have registered. People have registered in Nakuru, in Nairobi now. It is becoming an explosion in Nairobi. I've seen people providing help in Nairobi in this week on Tuesday. Somebody provided help of $10,000. That is about a million Kenya shillings. Another person provided help of $1,000. Another one, $3,000. Another one, $5,000, half a million. So this is happening now in Nairobi. And they were asking that, where were you people all this time? And they said, this campaign which God has brought to us, that is what our people in Nairobi say. They are pastors, they are believers like you and me, and they are already saying, this is something God has brought to us, and we want to participate. Okay, let's look here. MMM, how does it work? How does it work? We can also call it peer-to-peer exchange of donation, which means people donate each other. You donate to somebody money, somebody also donate to some other person, and in the end of the day you also receive donation from somebody, members of the community. Now it means this 200 million members who are in the community, every one of them has decided to say, I want to donate for free to somebody. For free. Underline that one. For free. I want to donate for free to somebody. Let me bring this one here. I want to donate for free to somebody. I want to donate for free. I want just to illustrate something. Because there is a big question that I've already donated $100.